The narrative about the Phoenix Suns is that they took advantage of injuries in the playoffs, and after going up 2-0 in last spring's finals, they showed off their true colors as chokers. But proving those chronicles wrong, winners of a 21-22 season most 9 straight games now, Phoenix has a ridiculous 7 players averaging double-figure scoring, getting W's with a balanced offensive attack. In the wild, wild west, where there's legitimately 4-6 title contenders, you're about to find out every reason for why the powerhouse reigning conference champions have unfinished business and could easily get to the finals again in 2022. Before continuing, only 23.8% of you watching are subscribed, so please subscribe. Also, leave a thumbs up on this video. It takes a few seconds and makes a massive difference. And stay tuned for Community Speaks at the end. 4 straight defeats to the Milwaukee Bucks when CP3 was on the verge of ring number 1 lost Phoenix a lot of believers and had a lot of people unfairly labeling them as chokers. I don't know how this team got almost zero respect after getting through the West easily, taking care of their business, and getting 2 wins from hoisting the Larry. I know they faced injured teams, but you play who's in front of you. And the Suns won handedly in 3 straight series, plus it's not like their top players' production fell off in the finals. Paul averaged 22-8 on 55% from the field and 49% from deep. Booker did shoot just 22% from 3-point range, but as I'll get to, his deep range shot has improved from last year. But D-Book still averaged 23 on 43% from the field in the finals. As I'll get to, Ayton was also very solid in the final series. The Suns' actual downfall was simply getting a tad comfortable after winning the first 2 games of the finals at home, with all the youth and inexperience surrounding CP3, and running into a hungrier Bucks team. So they may have lost 4 straight on the biggest stage, but let's not completely lose hope in the Suns. Game 5 in Phoenix against the Bucks could have gone either way, and the team put up a hell of a fight last year, going from a non-playoff team to the West champs. But all they've gotten from the mainstream media and fans is disrespect. Today, that changes. After coughing up a 2-0 lead in the 2021 finals, that may not have been the 36-year-old Chris Paul's last chance to win a ring after all, as despite some headlines regarding rumors about the Phoenix Suns owner being like Donald Sterling and the team not agreeing to an extension with DeAndre Ayton, collectively, the Suns have put the BS aside and realized they have a chance to make up for their collapse in last spring's championship series and achieve the ultimate goal in June of 2022. The steaming Suns, who've got a boatload of talent from shifty backcourt stars to low-post beasts up front, are currently on the franchise's longest win streak since 2010. In that year, Phoenix came up 2 wins short of making the finals. Of course, this past postseason, the Suns came up 2 wins short of becoming world champs. But unlike the team they faced in the finals in the Bucks, who are struggling right now, the Suns haven't gotten caught up in what they achieved last year. This team is focused and in the moment. Speaking on the win streak, Coach Monty Williams said, quote, "I don't take the wins for granted. The guys probably look at me sometimes. They wonder if I'm happy because my deadpan expression confuses them. I love the wins, but I'm also focused on us getting better." End quote. I know he doesn't want to be compared to Kobe, but D-Book was resembling the Black Mamba last night with the stone-cold daggers he was draining in Minneapolis. Devin Booker's been a bit more efficient from 3-point range this season than he was last year, and he's taking one more attempt from out there on average each night. In addition to his deep range stroke, another area of D-Book's game that's improved is his defense. I think he's always been an underrated player on this end of the floor, but 2021-22's validated Booker's legit impact to helping his team get stops defensively. Booker's averaging a career-high 1.1 steals per game, and he's among some of the most valuable stoppers at his position. Devin currently ranks number 6 among all shooting guards in defensive rating. His scoring may be down this year, but don't let that make you assume that the rest of his game has fell off. He's having an exceptional season. In his return from a right leg contusion, which kept him out 5 games and 11 days, DeAndre Ayton posted a stat line of 22-11 on 10 of 14 shooting. In case you forgot how much of an absolute phenom up front Ayton is, he reminded you of his beastliness last night. In the NBA Finals last spring, Ayton was the top performing center on the floor, averaging 15 points, 11 boards to go along with 1.5 steals and 1.5 blocks per game. If it wasn't for Ayton leading all players in the 2021 playoffs in offensive rebounding, the Suns wouldn't have made it out of the West. DeAndre's overpowering blend of agility, strength, vertical jump, and his 7'5" wingspan allow him to seamlessly keep possessions alive at a league-best pace. Additionally, in the post, Ayton nicely mixes together drop steps and hooks with his fluent footwork and soft touch around the basket. He ranked number 9 in between Chris Middleton and Kawhi in total points put up while backing down in the post. Before the 2021 Executive of the Year and GM and former NBA champion as a player, James Jones got the job. Former general manager Ryan McDonough picked Mikal Bridges 10th overall in 2018. Since being a lottery pick 3 years ago, Mikal's added new elements to his repertoire. You can tell when players are making steady progression, both evidently with their play and with their numbers statistically, that over the summer, they're putting in endless reps in the gym and their workhorses. Bridges has always been a lockdown defending wing, but game by game, over these last few seasons, slowly but surely, he's developed into one of the most reliable offensive players that fans in the Valley can count on consistently. Just like the backbone that DeAndre's rebounding, rim protecting, and inside finishing provides, the floor spacing that Mikal's three-point shooting provides is absolutely fundamental to Phoenix's success. But the current GM, James Jones, deserves the credit for this team's success because he was the one who brought in the most important piece to this team last offseason in CP3. Jones also hasn't gotten complacent, which he could have easily done after the team had made the finals. This summer, James Jones made some under-the-radar upgrades on the perimeter that have the potential to severely help the team's chances when the 2022 postseason hits. Going from Shaqton MVP to NBA champion and now proficient backup five-man in the Valley, JaVale McGee's leading the Suns in blocks per game, and he did an outstanding job of filling in for Ayton when he was out. Sometimes McGee can miss easy layups, but his 7 rebounds per game, and as I mentioned, his rim protection with that shot blocking, all of those qualities are making a massive impact for his new team in Phoenix. If there was one thing Phoenix needed to get better at, it was their three-point shooting. The team ranked number 11 among all teams in the 2021 playoffs in three-pointers made, so the trade of Javon Carter in exchange for Nets sharpshooter Landry Shamet was big time. Landry's shot around an elite 40% three-point clip in each of his 5 years in the NBA. There's also still some untapped potential with Shamet, given he's only 24 years old. But overall, based off their top players' efficiency in last year's postseason, which you wouldn't expect based off all the choking narratives that fans have put out there, combined with the multitude of legit 10 to 20 point bucket getters they have, I think Phoenix has a great chance at making another deep playoff run in 2022. For next video shout out, who's your favorite player on the Suns and why? Today's shout-out goes to Ona, who says, I remember Stephen A. Smith saying that he was unsure if Zach and DeMar could coexist on the court together like a month ago. Boy, he should have been very sure at this point. They play so well off each other. Pause to read the rest of Ona's amazing take. The top three commenters with the most shout-outs by the 25th of December are going to receive NBA merchandise in the holiday season, so leave your take on today's question to compete in Community Speaks. This was D-Flow, and I'll see you next video.